Hey guys, I just wanted to hop on here and say hello because I have a really busy day today. First, I'm heading to the gallery that I'm showing at right now and gonna have an interview, talk about Stuck a little bit, and also talk about my new collection. But yeah, just a part of the busy process we have going right now. So, see you later. Hey guys, so I'm about to film my portion and I come to the bathroom to get ready.
He likes my diamonds and my
And another one of my art pieces is
I
right here
said,
in the
thank you, I
bathroom.
designed it. Not your average girl. You need a swag and I'll provide it. Bite it. Open up and bite it. Bite it. Open up and bite it. Bite it. Open up and bite it. Bite it. Shut up, boy, you bite it.
All right, so I just got finished filming at Oakstop for the art show that I'm currently in. But Oakstop in general, they are partners of Stuck Designs. We have many community partnerships, and that is definitely a highlight of Stuck Designs and what we do.
Already got the cheddar, yeah. Now that boy with me, he gon' spend it better, yeah. Put him on an Alex, Gucci on his wallet, Recco hands on me. They think I'm his stylist. Bite it. He likes my diamonds and my pearls. I said, thank you, I designed it.
Yeah, so with Oakstop, I was able to show my own stuff, but if we ever want to have an event, we can also use Oakstop for that. We can use it for personal shows, to show our Stuck Girl collection. It's many possibilities. To me, because of my passion for art as well as mental health advocacy. When I was about five, and in kindergarten, I lived in Orange County. And I remember doing art for one of the first times. And in the class, our teacher pulled out the box of crayons and she pulled out an orange crayon and she said, "You color this lightly, and that is skin color, that's skin tone." And I remember sitting there like when I was five and looking down at like my own hand, like that's not my skin color, but I was the only girl of color in the class, like out completely. And probably the school and probably our neighborhood. So quickly after that, my mom relocated us to Oakland, which at the time was definitely a diverse cultural melting pot. So I went from one extreme kind of to another. And so I have perspectives of being the only Black girl and perspectives of being in a very diverse environment. But being in the art world and developing as an artist, being in art classes, since about that age, I was often the only. In most classes, I was the only. And there's a very strong feeling behind that, like just of being the only Black girl. It's very awkward, like you can't believe it yourself, like the teachers usually would, but it's like once you get higher up in the art world, you start seeing less and less color. And so I really want to change that for Black girls. Right now, I feel like there's slim to none representation of Black girls. And it's just like, that shouldn't be. Like, why is that still happening? And why aren't people more upset about it? Like, why don't people care about this? So that's really my passion and why I'm so like purpose-driven about Stuck, because it has the ability to change the world. I really believe that it's a humanitarian issue. Currently, there are about, I would say, 5% women of color artists that are actually included in museums around the US. And that is such a small percentage. And by those museums, I mean like big museums like MoMA. But that is such a small percentage, and that shouldn't be. Like, that is not normal, that is not equal, that's not equitable. And it's because of like the just systematic racism and systematic structure that continues to exist and not present opportunities to girls of color. And it's not fair and it's not right. And we want it to stop. We want to give more girls opportunity for art resources, art supplies, which are super expensive, art classes, and we want them to be able to have creative careers and actually believe that they can have creative careers.